The figure contains 100 equally sized parts. Meta ratio comparing the shaded area to the total area for each figure in three different ways. Also represent the shaded area as a decimal and a percent. So because the ratio is comparing the shaded area to a total area, this would also be the fraction of the area that is shaded. Looking at the figure, this is a 10 by 10 grid, so there are a total of 100 equally sized parts. Let's determine how many of the 100 parts are shaded. There are 10 parts in each column, so we have 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85 shaded parts out of 100, and therefore the ratio of shaded area to total area is 85 to 100. And we can write this ratio three ways. We can write the ratio in fraction form, 85 over 100. We can also use the word 2, so 85 to 100. And we can also use a colon, 85 to 100. Again, because this is the ratio of shaded area to total area, 85 hundredths is also the fraction of the area that is shaded. Now we're asked to write the ratio in decimal form as well as percent. Well, if we know our place values, 85 hundredths is 0.85, which is the decimal. If we didn't know this, a ratio is comparing two numbers by division, so we could take 85 and divide by 100, which would give us 0.85. We're also asked to give the percent. A percent is a number compared to 100. 85 hundredths is equal to 85%. Before we go to the next example, though, I do want to mention we can simplify ratios just like we simplify fractions, which means we can express the ratio of the shaded area to total area using larger parts or pieces. For example, let's divide this 10 by 10 grid into 20 equally sized parts. Notice by doing this, we now have a total of 20 equally sized parts, 17 of which are shaded, and therefore we can also express the ratio of shaded area to total area as 17 to 20. And again, this can be expressed in three ways. As a fraction, 17 to 20, using the word 2, 17 to 20, as well as using a colon. If you look at the ratio in fraction form, notice how 85 and 100 share a common factor of 5, so if we divide the numerator and denominator by 5, notice how this does give us the fraction 17 20ths, or the ratio of 17 to 20. Let's look at another example. Same question, different grid. So we know there's 100 equally sized parts here. Let's determine how many are shaded. Well, there's 50 shaded parts here on the left, so we have 50, 52, 54, 56, 58. There are 58 shaded parts out of a total 100 equally sized parts, and therefore the ratio of shaded area to total area is 58 to 100. And let's write the ratio three ways in fraction form, using the word 2, and also using a colon. As a decimal, the fraction 58 hundredths is equal to 0.58. 58 hundredths as a percent is 58%. But again, we can simplify a ratio just like we simplify a fraction, which means we can express the ratio of shaded area to total area using larger parts or pieces. If we recognize that 58 and 100 share a common factor of 2, we can create an equivalent ratio by dividing the numerator and denominator by 2. This will give us 29/50, or a ratio of 29 to 50, which means we can also express this area by dividing the 10 by 10 grid into 50 equally sized parts. 29 of the parts would be shaded. I hope you found this helpful.